In this lecture, we are going to discuss on logistic regression multi-class classification. So in the last class, we have seen how to consider the binary classification problem using logistic regression. And today we'll see the multi-class classification. So multi-class classification, as you can see here in that particular category, you will find that there are different classes, like it can be democratic, Republican or independent. Okay, in binary classification, it is only the two different classes are present. Okay, so these kind of problems are multi-class classification. So today we are going to solve a problem that will identify handwritten digit. Okay, so your input data here or the features are basically the image, handwritten digits, and your output or the target basically having these different classes, like it can be 0, 1, 2 or up to 9. So there are 10 different digits that can be the answer, or that can be the solution of a particular image. So it is a multi-class classification. Here you can see there are 10 different classes are there in the target, 10 different classes. In case of a binary classification, we have seen only yes or no. There are only two classes there. But here, there are 10. Out of these 10, it can be any one of them. That is why this is a multi-class classification problem. So now, how to deal with the image data? We know that the data, when they are in a numeric form, we can do some operation, we can do some calculations, right? But how to convert this image into numbers, that we'll see first. And then we'll convert accordingly and do apply the logistic regression. So for this problem, let us first see that we are going to consider a digit data set that will contain 1797 image. That means around 1800 images are there. And each image is 8x8 pixel size. So here, in this diagram, you can see one image that has been shown, which is 28x28 pixel. But the data set on which we are going to work, that is 8x8 pixel. Okay. Now, these data are basically, it can be like this, maybe 0, 1, like this. And in this way, total 1800 images are there. Okay. Now, if we consider, let us consider this particular example to say this is one of the digit, handwritten digit, and here it is 28x28, but in our case it will be 8x8, but the basic idea is same. So here you can see that each pixel, corresponding to each pixel, it is assigned a particular number. Here you can see there are, corresponding to each pixel, some number is assigned. These are very small, that is why probably you can't see. So if you take one particular pixel from here, and if we magnify, we can see that the number which is written as, say, 0.51. Okay, similarly, here at this point, the number which is written is 0. If you see here in the white region, you will find the number which is written as 1. So you can understand, basically, the black is indicated by 0 and white is indicated by 1, and the other shades are always between 0 to 1. So minimum to maximum. In our case, this is a scale data. That is why it is showing in that way. In our case, you will find that the data is varying from 0. These pixel values are actually grayscale values corresponding to the pixel, will vary from 0 to 15. Okay, so 0 corresponding to black, similar here, and the 15, which is the maximum value of the pixel or the grayscale, that is 15. Okay, if you just simply scale this range, then it will be it can be converted into 0 to 1. It is exactly the similar thing. Here you can see one of the digit of this digit data set on which we are going to work, you can see 8x8, Total 64 numbers are there, 8x8, and each of the numbers are written here in the form of an array. You can see 0, 0, 5, 13, 9. So you can see the maximum value, which is the 15, and the minimum value, which is the 0. And all other values should be 0 to 15. But basic idea is exactly same. Here, minimum and maximum is only 0 to 1. And in our case, it will be 0 to 15 in the data. Okay. So this is about the numbers, which is actually hidden within the image. Okay, so it is possible by some command to get those numbers out of the image. So if it is not a grayscale image, in that case, it is possible that even RGB image, that means if you take one image from your camera, it is possible that converting that RGB image into grayscale image, and then from the grayscale image, you can get this numbers corresponding to that image. Okay, so we'll see that what are those Python commands, but this is the basic idea. So corresponding to each number, you can understand that corresponding to each number or each handwritten digit, corresponding to each image, basically you have an array of 64 numbers like this. Okay, so basically now what is there in your data set, you can understand that corresponding to each image, you have an array of 64, set of 64 numbers, and corresponding to that, maybe some target is there. You know that it is, say, 9. Okay, so this is what is the target. Okay, and here again, some combination of 64, and corresponding to that, suppose it is labeled, that is, say, 7. Like this. So this kind of a data, suppose available around 1800 data, such 1800 such data is available. So with that data, basically we'll try to train our model. Okay. So this is what is the idea. And now we'll go and simply implement this concept. Okay. So let's go to the Python notebook, and first give the title that we are going to solve this one, logistic regression, multi-class classification problem, and the objective. So in the text cell, definitely in the text cell, you paste it. This is not a code. This is basically the heading. Now, first, what we are going to do, we have to load the digit, okay? This data set, we have to load the data set. So first, from sklearn, you can see from sklearn data sets, you import load digits, okay? And you also import matplotlib for visualization that will be required. I think you can understand the codes. Basically, we are importing load digits, and we have given this load digits a name, simple digits. Okay, so now digits is that particular data set that we have. Now, if you just run it or execute it, then it will be loaded. Okay, so the data set is now loaded. Now, what we want to do, we want to see the images in the grayscale, okay? In the grayscale images that we want to see. And for that, you are going to use that plt.gray, okay? So execute it for the first 5 values. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. You see that for I in, look at this command line carefully. So for I in range 5, that means it will take the first 5 values, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So these first 5 values it will take. It will not consider the 5 that you know already in a for command. In the range, it is written in that way. Then plt dot mat show within bracket digits dot images. Okay, digits dot images. And we know that how many images are there. We know there are around 1800 images. But what we want to see? We want to see only the first 4 images. Okay, so we have given the index I. And this I will take values from in 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4. Okay, so first 5 values it will take, and those images you can see using this command, that plot plt dot mat show. Okay, and here you can see the first 4 images, so first 5 images you can see here. Now if you want to see that what is there within this digits data set, in the whole data set, what is there within that? So for that, you will see all the attributes and methods that is present in this digits. You can see there is description, there is data, there are images, target, and target names. Okay, so see some of the things you can simply just see that what are the things there, different attributes and methods that is present within that. So data is basically, if you want to see what is there within the data, so you just write digits.data and give the first data for that digits 0, what is there corresponding to index 0. Okay, so then you will see that what is there within it. Check what is there within digits dot data 0. So you can see that at 0 level or the 0 index, the data actually contain an array of 64 numbers. So this basically indicates a single image. Okay, this basically indicates a single image. And if you want to know what is that image, then how you can see that? Here you see the images. So what you can do, you just simply write digits dot images and you write the 0, the at the same index what is there, then you'll see this set of numbers indicates which image. Okay, but to see that particular image, what command you have to give? That you know, the command that you have to give, plt dot mat show. Then you can see that particular image in this format. Okay, so plt dot mat show, if you write before that, plt dot mat show, and if you execute, then you see this particular image which actually corresponds to this particular data.
Zero.
Okay, so that data is 0, and you can understand that how this is happening. You see that this is 0, 0 means black, and then it is again 0, black, then it is 5, like that. Okay, so this is how the data is there. So data you have understood, images you have understood, what is there in the image corresponding to the data, there are images. Okay, then what is the target? Target means it is all the level data, that means corresponding to that image, what is the actual, this is handwritten digit, right? So what is the actual number corresponding to that. That is there within the target. And if you want to see that, so exactly in a similar way, you can write that digits dot target. And if you want to see only the first data, then you can put like this, and you can check what is there. And you see that it is zero. Okay, so if you want to see that what is actually there in digits dot target, you see it is basically a label like 0, 1, 2, 3 in this way. All the images corresponding to what actual number that image corresponds to, that is there. So that is the target column that is there, and you can see all the around 1800 values are there. Here you can see dot dot dot. That means all the 1800 values are there in this array corresponding to each image. Okay, so that means this is what is target. Okay, so let me share this with you. And you please execute that and check. Okay, so after that, what is there in the data set? That is target names. Okay, so target names means the different classes that is present. What are the different classes present? We know there are total 10 classes present. What are those 10 classes? 0, 1, 2, 10. So target names basically indicates the number of classes or the classes that is present here. Okay, so if you execute, you see that it is giving that what are the different classes present. Okay, so these are basically the unique values that is taken from the target column. Okay, so you can understand what this digit data set actually looks like. Okay, so now what we have to do? So we have now everything. So we have to create X and Y, and then we have to split the data, and then we have to train the data. And finally,
can you tell me again what is the target converse?
Target. Target means corresponding to each image, corresponding to each 800 image, there is one particular value, that particular handwritten digit corresponding to which number. Okay, so that is what is the target column. Understood? So target column also having the 1800 values. Clear? And
sir, bujhaben sir, target value set bujhlam sir.
Target value means, you see, these are all labeled data, na? We have to train. So we have to train with the known data, labeled data. You have handwritten digits, and these handwritten digits corresponding to which number, that is already known to us. Some of the data that is known to us, we have not yet trained our model. Once the model will be trained, after that it will be able to recognize any other handwritten digits. Okay, so first of all, you have to give the labeled data, na? So corresponding to each image, some number, that is what is that particular image, that is already there. With those data, basically we will train, na? So target column indicates that what is that number indicates corresponding to that handwritten image. Okay,
so may I ask a question, sir?
Yes, Ayush.
So I'm actually at a logic tag by jiggesh korchi seta hocche je dhoron ekta basic mane page dewa ache, there are multiple pixels on the page. Every single pixel, মানে ধরুন একটা জিনিস আমি ড্র করলাম, এখন প্রত্যেকটা নাম্বারের জন্য তার সেট সেট অফ গাইডলাইন আছে, কোন একটা ড্যাশ বা কোন একটা হরিজন্টাল বা ভার্টিক্যাল লাইন, তো এখানে যে পিক্সেলস গুলো আছে, এভরি সিঙ্গেল পিক্সেল হ্যাজ এ পার্টিকুলার হাউজিং, যেখানে ইট রেকগনাইজেস যে ওইখানটা দ্য ড্যাশ উইল পাস থ্রু দ্যাট পার্টিকুলার পিক্সেল, তো এখন যখন আমরা এটা দিচ্ছি এটা হ্যান্ড রিটেন, আমাদের প্রত্যেকটা পিক্সেল ইজ ট্রাইং টু রেকগনাইজ যে ইফ ইট ইজ পার্ট অফ দ্যাট সিস্টেম, তো ম্যাক্সিমাম কেস সিনারিও যেটা মানে পিক্সেল গুলো অ্যাকসেপ্ট করবে যে হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে এটা ড্যাশটা পাস করছে, দেন ইট উইল রেকগনাইজ.
নো নো নো, ইট ইজ বেসিক্যালি দ্য ব্রাইটনেস, ইট ইজ টেকিং দ্য হোয়াট ইজ দ্য ব্রাইটনেস ভ্যালু করসপন্ডিং টু দ্যাট পজিশন, দ্যাটস অল. grayscale means basically the grayscale value means corresponding to the grayscale means the, what is the brightness value.
Whether recognize kore ki kore byapar ta shesh porjonto
no brightness can be recognized na whether it is a black or a white or a medium, so that brightness is recognized na. So corresponding to that some number is assigned. If it is black, then some number is assigned. If it is white, zero, then all intermediate values will be assigned some value. So that algorithm is there. That algorithm is there within that grayscale command. Okay.
Bujhlam sir. Okay sir.
Okay. Now, after understanding these, what are the different things present within the digits, then we need two things. One, we need the data. We no longer need the images because we know that each image corresponding to the data, because the data actually contain the numbers corresponding to that image. So basically this is going to our X, and what is going to our Y? Our Y is going to be corresponding target. So we actually required this data as X and the target as Y. Okay, so accordingly we will prepare our X and Y. That will be our next job, and after that we'll split and create the model. That is as usual. So let us do that. So create and train our logistic regression model. So for that, what we do? So first, you have to do. You give this heading in a text cell. Remember, this is not a code one. This is a text cell. Anton Saptashbo, mute.
Sir, have been muted.
Okay. Next, what you do from the sklearn dot linear model import logistic regression that we know, and you create model. Give the name model to logistic regression, considering some iteration, say 200, and execute this. So you have created now model, and then we import train test split. Import train test split. And split the data. And you can consider 80-20 division. We have given test size is equal to 0.2. So what is our X and Y that we have considered? You see, yes.
Hello sir, bolchi error asche to amar etate.
Where?
Sir, 9.
In step 9.
Yes. No, sir.
Okay. Yeah, error or warning?
Sir, error, sir. I think some mistake. Just sorry, sir. Mistake.
Okay. So what we are going to do? Let's execute this. And then import test train test split, and here you see what is our X and what is our Y. You observed digits dot data, that is our X, clear? And what is our Y? You see digits dot target. Okay, so corresponding to this data and data corresponding to each image, what is the target? So this is X and this is Y, and now split this data in 80-20 proportion, and that is why we have given test underscore size is equal to 0.2. So this is the standard procedure. Then we will fit this model with the train data. Okay, the train data that will be created out of it, X train, Y train, that with that we will train our logistic regression model. So using fit method, you do that, Okay, so some warning is coming. Maybe there are two reasons the warning is coming. You see that this warning will come. One is that might be the number of iteration is to be increased, or the data is not properly scaled. These are the two reasons that it is showing. So iteration, you can understand that in that case you have to increase the number of iteration from 200 to 400 like that. And what is the meaning of this scaling the data? Scaling the data means, here you can see the data is 0 to 15, right? The data actually vary from 0 to 15. So by scaling means you can convert this from 0 to 1. Okay, so this is what is the meaning of scaling that you can do. There are other ways by which also scaling can be done, but this is a simple way, and you can do that scaling. In that case, this warning is not going to come. So for that, there is something standard. It is very simple how to convert it from 0 to 1. Just divide by the maximum number, that is the 15. If you divide all the numbers by 15, it will be scaled. Or by using some command, you can also do that. And that suggestion has been given here in the first link that has been provided. If you just click on that, you see that how we can scaling it. One of the method you will observe, that is the standard scaler. Okay, so import pre-processing from the sklearn, that is the first thing. And then what you have to do from pre-processing, the standard scaler, this you have to use, and then fit xtrain, and then the scaler will be scaled. Okay, there are other different methods by which it can be done. Here you can see using the pipeline that we'll do later in a later example, maybe other day. Using pipeline, you can use that, or many tasks can be actually given within the pipeline. We'll see how to use the pipeline afterwards when we'll compare the different kinds of model. But here you can see the two objective, two work that is done with the pipeline. One is the standard scaler, that means the scaling, and another one is the logistic regression performance. So you can just take this code snippet to scaling also. So this can be done, but we are ignoring for the time being. We are not doing it. Let it be, since it is not an error. It's just giving some warning that some more convergence is required to achieve some very low error. Anyway, next is what you have to do is measure the accuracy of our model. So how to measure the accuracy of our model, that we know using the score method, dot score, that you have to use. And find out what is the accuracy of this. So it is coming 0.975. Okay, it is coming 0.975. That means it's a very good model that we have trained. You say we have tested with X test, Y test. Remember, when we have trained our model, this X test, Y test, the model have not seen before. Okay, so when it is tested with the unseen data, X test, Y test, it is performing well. 97.5%, it's good. So finally, you can also see the model.predict from 0 to 5. So what is the meaning of this command? Let us first try to understand. Don't execute first. First try to understand what is the meaning of this line. I'm sharing it with you. Yes.
Sir, amar to sir ase 0.96111.
Okay, it may happen because we have not fixed our data set. In a trained split, the different kinds of splitting may be possible. I have already told you. Unless otherwise, we fix the particular splitting by random underscore size, it may be different for each execution. Okay, now coming to this one, model.predict. Digits dot data 0 to 5. What is the meaning of that? It will take the data from 0 to 4. It will take the data from the index 0 to 4. You can understand 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This first four index data it will take. And according to the model, it will predict what are the those values. Okay, so we already know what are the those values. Model.predict digits data. Let's check what it is giving. Yes, it is giving absolutely all right. So we know that in the first four values, basically model is predicting this data corresponding to these numbers, and which is actually true because initially we have seen that what are the actual images corresponding to 0 to 5. We have seen what are the first five images. You know, first five images, you see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. These were the first five images. And you see the model is also predicting the same. Model is also predicting the same. The first five images, it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So our model is performing well. Okay, now next is we can see that how our model performed in a visual plot using the confusion matrix. And this is a very this is a very standard one. In a text box, you just give heading confusion matrix. And first, what we are doing, we are creating, you see, we have created y underscore predict, which is basically the prediction of the x test data. Okay, x test data, if we predict through our model, then that is stored within y predict. Okay. So the test data we are going to see, okay? And from sklearn.matrix, we have to import confusion matrix. And this is the code. You just use it. So confusion matrix, we have given the name, say CM. Within CM, we want to see what is the confusion matrix. So confusion matrix, and within that, we are passing the parameters y underscore test, y underscore predict. So y underscore predict is basically how our model is predicting, and y underscore test is what are the actual values corresponding to those x test. Okay, these are the actual values which is leveled, which is in the target, and y predict how our model is predicting corresponding to those values. Okay, now if we see what is the confusion matrix, then you just execute and you see this is the visualization. The visualization can be improved using the Seaborn. Seaborn is again another very important library like matplotlib. Seaborn is also very useful. Here you see that we can import Seaborn as SN, and you just use it. And execute the same thing, but with some colorful effect you will find. And you see this kind of a map. Okay, so what this confusion matrix actually tells you, this thing is exactly same what you can see in this array, basically the same thing, but visually it is very attractive, you can see, but you have to understand what is the meaning of this. The meaning is, here you can see in the x level it is the predicted, and in the y level it is truth. That means you see that 36 times it is actually zero and it is predicted zero. So total 36 zero is there, and all the 36 cases it is predicted correctly. So if it is along the diagonal, that means the predicted value is same as what is the actual leveled value. But here you see 1, for the digit handwritten digit one, actually there are two values you can see which is not at the diagonal position. So 29 times it is predicted correctly that one is predicted one, but two times it is predict, actually it is two, but it is predicted one. You see, this is the predicted value. So two values which are not actually one, which is actually two, but wrongly it is predicted as one. Okay, so which are out of diagonal, those are basically the wrong prediction. Here you can see there is one value which is predicted one, but actually that was four. Okay, here you can see there is one value which is predicted one, but actually it is eight. Okay, so some mistakes also this model is making, because you have seen that it is having 97% in our case, model accuracy you have seen. So what are the deviations that you can see visually from this particular heat map, from this particular confusion matrix? And you see that in most of the cases it is predicting correct. That means its predicted value is exactly same what is the true value. Some of the cases you can see some deviation is there. That means here you can see with the digit it is predicted 8, but actually it is not 8. In one case it is not 8, it is actually 9, but it is predicted 8. In two cases it is actually 1, but it is predicted 8. So in this way we read the confusion matrix. Okay, so our next job is to do this exercise problem. So where we'll use the IRIS dataset, and from that we'll categorize the four different we will categorize the three different classes are there of the flowers, iris flowers, based on four features. Sorry. Okay. So from the iris dataset, in iris dataset, the dataset is such that you will find that there are four different features that is present, and corresponding to that, there is a target where basically three different classes present, three different types of flower, iris flower that is there. So your job is to train this particular multi-class problem